Well, this channel isn't going to be abandoned anytime soon. Most people know or have at least heard about the previous two featured animals, the great auk and the quagga. So how about we look at a group of extinct birds that aren't well known to the public but are worth introducing? Ladies and gentlemen, the Hawaiian honeyeaters. Since little is known about this family, it made my research a lot more difficult than the other two. So I'm going to mention the needed characteristics. With that being said, let's begin. The Hawaiian honeyeaters, or mohoidai, were a family of birds that lived in the subtropical forests on the Hawaiian Islands. There are two genera in this family, the kaoia birds and the moho birds. The overall length of the honeyeaters ranged from 20 to 33 centimeters. The moho birds had black and yellow colors, while the kaoian birds had broad black stripes on their faces and bristle-like patterns on their heads and chests. As the name suggests, these birds were nectarivores that used their curved bills to collect nectar from plants. Sources of nectar included oia lewa trees, lapa lapa trees, and Hawaiian lobelioids. Additionally, they also ate fruits and insects. Most of their hunting didn't take them far from the area around the nest. These birds breed sometime between late May and early June, likely once per year. Males and females engage in melody duets and they mate for life. The birds made their nests in the cavities of old-growth trees in low-elevation subtropical forests. The females may have laid several clutches in the elliptical-shaped nest, though the number of eggs laid is unknown. The Hawaiian honeyeaters were thought to belong to the family of Meliphagidae due to their similarities in appearance, behavior, diet, and other details. However, in 2008, a study claimed, based on the analysis of DNA from stuffed specimens, that the genera of these Hawaiian birds aren't closely related to the Meliphagidae. Instead, they belong to a group within the Passerida. The Hawaiian and House Thalassian honeyeaters did not evolve from a common ancestor, but instead represent a case of convergent evolution, which means separate evolution featuring similar species.
Well, now here comes the ugly part.
The Hawaiian honeyeaters weren't so lucky to live long enough because, unsurprisingly, human activity kicked those birds to extinction. Habitat destruction in favor of expanded farms, hunting, and deforestation played a major role in the decline of the bird. But things got worse when the Europeans brought invasive species to the tropical islands. This is something that I forgot to elaborate quickly previously, so I'm going to do it right now. Each time an ecosystem receives unwanted guests, the ecosystem and its native species are going to be poisoned. And by poisoned, I mean screw up the natural order. No exceptions. So, which species harm the honeyeaters? Simple. Pigs, mongooses, rats, and... mosquitoes. The disease carrier demons. Picture this. These birds didn't have natural predators before. So of course they were not prepared for what was to come. As a result of the combination of awful events, the Hawaiian honeyeaters population declined quickly. The kaoia o'o had the worst ending of them all. The species had to move to higher elevation forests due to the disappearance of the kaoia lowland forests. However, those higher elevation trees didn't provide many favors, as the plants there lacked suitable cavities for the nest. And if that wasn't bad enough, the hurricanes came out of nowhere and blew away everything these birds had left, ultimately destroying the species forever!
This is a song recording of a male o'o singing on Kauai. He is the last male of a species singing for a female who will never come. And now his voice is gone.
The more we think about the extinction of the Hawaiian honeyeaters, the worse the feeling gets due to the lack of recognition from the general public. As a result, the information about them is limitedly scarce. So much so that I couldn't find how many specimens of this family exist in total. Which, in all seriousness, is not a deserving fate for them. It is so cruel to have a bird family that has both lost their voices and be completely forgotten by the public. This family of birds is worth studying, like every animal. You can also see a short animated film by Hanamation about the honeyeater, specifically about the Kauai Hoho. Beautifully made and emotional video, link in the description. Overall, it is worth giving this family of birds the recognition they deserve. Just like every animal that might be lost on Earth but not lost in their history.